I'm about to make some stupid faces on camera because I care about you. What's up, fishes? My name is Sarah Lotus, and today we're going to talk about toroidal bubbles. Toroidal bubbles are those bubble rings that you see people blow. They're kind of like the apex bubble trick for divers and mermaids. A quality toroidal bubble will not have a lot of broken up little bubbles, so what we're aiming for is a nice crisp ring right around you. And I'll insert me doing that right here.
I'm telling you a tale of the bottomless blue and its hay to the starboard heave-ho.
So there's two things that we're going to talk about. We're going to talk about things to make blowing a toroidal bubble easier when you're practicing, and then we're going to talk about the techniques that you use. So first, let's talk about things that you should bring with you when you're practicing. You're going to want some goggles and a nose plug. The reason being, when you're laying on your back underwater, it's going to try to go up your nose, and you want to be able to see the quality of your bubbles, so that's pretty easy. The next thing, dive belt. If you're fighting underwater, you're going to run out of air sooner, and you're not going to be able to bring as much air into your lungs for practice. And let's be real here, my tips aren't going to instantly make you do this. You're going to have to get into the pool and try a lot of times in a row. Please don't drown because I told you to get a dive belt. You guys know what these are? There's little weights on there, and each person needs a different weight based off of their buoyancy. And it's just a belt that straps around. I've seen some super cute mermaids like put starfish and stuff like that here and use it in their tails. So that's worth researching, but it's not my fault if you're stupid when you're using these, okay? So now that we've talked about some of the tools that you're gonna use when you do this, let's talk about technique. So a toroidal bubble, you're gonna lower yourself to the bottom of the pool. And the first thing a lot of people do when they go underwater, so I just want to make sure you know not to do this, is they do this. That's not holding any extra air in your body. So when you inhale, remember we're bringing air into our lower abdomen. We're inflating our ribs farther away from each other. We're taking a final little poof of air up in the top of our chest. And then we're going to go down. And we're going to relax our face. And we're going to lay on our back. You can put your arms anywhere that looks good in your frame. The next thing you're going to do is you're going to purse your lips and stick your tongue out. And the reason why you stick your tongue out is it makes a little hole for the air to pop around before it wraps into the bubble, because it's a toroidal bubble, because it's the whole ring is wrapped around itself. And when you purse your lips, it creates the O. And then you're going to burst a little bit of air out of it. So it'll look a little bit like this. And, okay, let me try this again.
It's so bad. I know exactly what I told you not to do.
Okay, so the first step, we're going to purse our lips, stick our tongue out. And then we're going to burst that air out of it. Now, you want it to be like a pulse of air, so you want it to stop. And when we do that, we're going to close our mouth, and that's what kind of seals it. So when you're underwater, again, and that's how you do a toroidal bubble. Of course, it takes a lot of practice. I don't know if I explained this the best I can. That's why it took me a while to post this video. But what I really think matters the most on this is watch some videos on it with people that are a little bit better at explaining it with their face, because I just kind of do it a little bit better underwater than out of water. But the goggles and the diving belt, that's going to help so much. If you can have a full breath of air and you're not like fighting to stay at the bottom of the pool, you're just going to have more bubbles per dive that you're going to be able to try to do. And then bonus points, if you do it pretty deep, the bubbles get really big and then you can swim through them. Sometimes you can go like, and you can... What will happen is one of the bubbles will be in front and then the other one will be a little bit faster, so it'll shoot through it and then wrap around it. And that's really fun as well. I don't have that on camera, but it was great talking to you guys. I hope this helps. Let me know if you couldn't do bubbles before and then you could do them after. I would love to see your progress. Also, if this helped improve in any way, or If you have tips that you can provide for everybody else, that would really be helping me out. So post them below in the comments. Have a great day, fishes, and happy swimming.
Will I be testing the mic, man?